In the hinterland of central China's Hubei province, a once impoverished village bid farewell to poverty in 2019 through planting pomelos. This year, residents of Huolong village in Jiangsu county have given another boost to the pomelo industry, leading to even better revenues. Robert Larkin, an American professor at a local university, has personally witnessed the village's improvements. On November 24, 2020, Larkin revisited Huolong village, where an e-commerce poverty relief event was held alongside the launch of a new pomelo variety, the Huolong Jade Emperor.
I'm very happy to see another bumper crop this year.
In China's poverty relief campaign, some universities have been urged to pair up with poverty-stricken regions to offer assistance. The school Larkin works for, Huazhong Agricultural University in Wuhan, was asked by authorities in 2012 to assist Jiangsu County. Since then, Professor Larkin and his colleagues have been helping visitors in Huolong to learn about pomelo cultivation. Huolong has a natural environment suitable for the planting of this citrus fruit. But because of a lack of expertise and sales channels, it hadn't brought in a stable income for villagers. Larkin and his colleagues improved the fruit's quality by teaching villagers about it and building a demonstration base. They have also explored the sales market by cooperating with leading enterprises and cooperatives. With the help of experts, more and more pomelo trees have been planted in the village.
I've never been to a village with so many, no. The density is very high. They have orchards full of grapefruit trees, and even in front of buildings, if they can find a small patch of soil.
For China's grassroots officials, poverty alleviation has been high on their agenda. Every time Larkin visits Huolong village, he meets Tom Ming, the party chief of Changliang Township, which governs Huolong. In 4 years, Tan has overseen construction of 4.7 kilometers of rural roads and blocking the bottleneck for the pomelo industry's development. Larkin says that in China, poverty alleviation is never the business of one person, one entity, or one locality. Instead, it's a major campaign that involves a significant part of society. As online sales increase in popularity, e-commerce training courses have been organized for Jiangsu County residents. Some villagers who couldn't even use smartphones before have started their own live streams to sell the local produce. With help from university experts, enterprises and the local government, Huolong has witnessed a boom in its pomelo industry. In 2019, almost all households in the village became involved in the planting of the fruit. With an annual output of 200,000 kilograms, the village saw its per capita annual income exceed 9,000 yuan. The whole village was lifted out of poverty and removed from the national poverty list. In 2020, the village's pomelo output exceeded 300,000 kilograms, and the per capita annual income has now topped 10,000 yuan. Huolong is just one of tens of thousands of villages in China that have shaken off poverty in the past several years. In just 8 years, China has lifted its entire population of rural impoverished residents under the current income standard out of poverty. Nearly 100 million poor people have risen above the poverty line, more than the entire population of Germany.
Well, I know that China has two 100-year goals, and one of these is to eradicate poverty. And I know that Chairman Xi Jinping strongly believes that no one should be left behind as China alleviates poverty and becomes a more wealthy and powerful nation. So I can see the advantages of the socialist system with my own eyes.